Oh shit.
From deep down inside, I wrote this sitting shotgun in my favorite ride. Reflecting on memories from my childhood, bringing a baby in this world. I hope my child good. All I ever gave a fuck about was my career, but all that shit out the window now that my son is here. Fuck sales and streams, none of that shit entails dreams. Fuck rap, fuck press, fuck feeling like I'm less. If it ain't about my happiness, then I could give a fuck less. I remember window shopping. Now I'm shopping for windows for my baby new room. Bobby coming soon. And that's the type of line I would have second guessed putting on my shit before. Out of fear that they would hate, cause they couldn't relate, cause it wasn't relevant. Give a fuck if it's evident. This right here is the evidence. I'm like Leo in Revenant. Bear with me. You could tear me apart, but that won't take away the fact I wrote this shit from the heart. Where it's been from the start, where it's finna stay. I've learned every day's a good day. Surrounded by people that love me, don't want nothing from me but my happiness. Off the internet, that's when I'm at my happiest. Scrolling so much, my thumb fucked up. We call that carpal tunnel vision. Follow me like religion on this course of collision. Feeling in prison, and this is my freedom through these lyrics as I repeat them and beat them into my conscience like a dinosaur.
I always let the day slip away. I should have been making up my mind. I never opened up to get all in, and now I'm running out of time. Sometimes I dream about going back, keeping all the things I left behind. But now I know you can't change the past. Way too young to know the reason why. And it all comes rushing back, rushing back. And it all comes rushing back, rushing back. And it all comes rushing back, rushing back. And it all comes rushing back.
This is not a comprehensive review of the DJI Mavic Mini. This drone's been out for a little while now. I mean, it's probably been almost a year or more than a year, maybe, I don't know. And if you are watching this video, you're either a subscriber, so welcome along, or you have stumbled upon it in search and you probably know what's going on with the drone. I don't need to go through all the specs and what it's like to fly and what its capabilities are. I mean, I'll touch on it a little bit, but this is kind of just like a personal experience with the drone. I've wanted to get into the drone game for a little while now, and it kind of stems from back in high school when our science department got a hold of a DJI Phantom 3 Pro, which was really crazy at the time. That's when drones were first kind of getting into the market, and DJI was kind of pioneering the innovation. And that was when the drones were huge, like way bigger than this. I used that drone to shoot a short film in 2016, and then in 2017 I used it to capture some cinematics of athletics and for various school project videos type thing. I don't know, probably be some b-roll on the screen right now, but it was amazing. Like, at the time, having access to that kind of thing to capture aerial footage was a game changer. And I mean, being inspired by Casey Neistat, who actually would use these Phantom drones. I think he's got a ton of Phantom 4s that he's broken, and that was back when those were like accessible and small. And then fast forward to now in 2020, 2019, we get this little guy, 249 grams. This thing is so light. And then if you take the battery out, all of the weights in the battery, which is wild to me. Like, this is a very capable drone. I mean, granted, it's not made out of the best materials, but obviously it's got to be that way to be this light. This thing can pretty much do everything that that Phantom 3 Pro or Phantom 4 pretty much. It can pretty much do what those drones do, and it's way smaller and a fraction of the cost. I'm in this for less than $600, and that Phantom 3 Pro setup we had at school was probably in at around $3,000. Since I plan on doing a little bit of traveling at the moment, only around New Zealand because COVID sucks, I thought it'd be pretty cool to have this piece of kit in my bag to capture some aerial cinematic footage if and when I have the opportunity. It captures 2.7K video, which is a weird resolution, but it's 16:9, and to be honest, it's really all I need. And if it's optimal conditions, I'm not gonna be flying this drone kilometers and kilometers away. I'm gonna try and keep it in line of sight, and you know, I do play it pretty safe, and maybe that's just me as a pilot at the moment, and maybe as I get better at flying, I can push it a little bit further. But yeah, like I said, it's really all I need. And for $600, like, if this thing breaks, it's not a major loss. I mean, I do have some kind of anxiety still when flying this drone, especially in wind. It is less nerve-wracking than trying to fly a school-owned $3,000 Phantom 3 Pro that, you know, you'd be in big trouble for if you crashed. That probably is more to do with me as a pilot than it is about any of the drones, though, to be honest. But, I mean, the only downside of this drone, as I mentioned before, and as kind of the title of the video suggests, is it is not good in wind. It being only 249 grams, there's potential for this thing to blow away in the wind, and the motors aren't the biggest in the world, so if it does get caught in a gust, it does not have the power to maintain hover, and therefore can blow away. And me being the genius that I am, here's me trying to fly this Mavic Mini in the Wellington wind yesterday. Also, excuse that I just got a haircut today, and I shot this following sequence the previous day before I got the haircut, so yeah, I realized with these videos that I've been doing lately, I've been playing jump rope with time, and I suck at continuity, so excuse me for that, but here's that footage. Okay, I have no idea if you guys can see me. This is gonna be the first maiden flight on camera. I mean, I've flown the drone before, but let's see what we can kind of do. I don't know, I just want to get a flight on camera. Let's just send it. There's a little bit of a breeze. It is Wellington after all, but is she gonna take off? There we go. So there we are. I don't know if the camera can pick it up. Oh, the controls are inverted, no. All right, I'm just gonna try and get it as close there, but that's the drone in flight. And let's try and get a little cinematic. The point has been updated. Please check it on the map. Looks like the wind conditions aren't too bad, so it's holding its own up there. Trying to bring her down nice and easy. Easy. It's really easy to fly. This is kind of like my front yard. It's a little bit boring, so I know of a place which is a little bit higher up, slightly better views, that we might be able to take this thing. So one thing that I really like about the Mavic Mini is the ability to, and excuse my lunch, is the ability to charge it with a power bank with micro USB. I mean, it is micro USB, which sucks. I wish it was USB-C, but I can essentially take a power bank or plug it into the car or whatever, and it's charging. And then I've also had to do some repairs to my box, because this is essentially the case for my Mavic Mini. I had to put some duct tape on there because the box tears, and it's such a weird design. There's no flaps on this end, and it basically it doesn't stay closed. I don't know. But I mean, in the meantime, this is going to be my case for the drone.
Yeah.
I mean, I didn't, like I said, I didn't buy the Fly More combo, so I didn't get the case and I didn't get the battery charger and all that, but I kind of just wanted the drone. So yeah, there you go. Nervous now. This is a spot. It's up the hill from my house. I don't know how well the drone's gonna do in this type of wind. I don't know if you can hear it. I've got my little dead cat on, so it's gonna dumb down a little bit of the noise. But I reckon I'm just gonna send it. Probably try and fly over there because that's like flat grass and it'll be easier to do some kind of search and rescue mission. To if I were to fly it out there, because there are a shit ton of houses that way. I don't know. Be a good wind test. I mean, it is Wellington and probably not the best place to fly a drone, but okay. So the wind is blowing this way. So I'm gonna take off and fly that way. And so the drone comes back with the wind, which I have figured out is kind of good practice from watching a few drone videos. The wind is, according to my Apple weather app, 24 kilometers an hour, which is probably the extent that this thing can fly in. A little bit nervous, but you know. Home point is updated. 97% on the battery, 11 satellites. Start recording. Oh shit! It's flying away. Okay, no, fuck that shit, I'm landing. Maybe. Doing like for a little drone like that though, it is not too bad. Let's see if we can get a little bit of altitude. Yep, strong wind warning, okay. See, it's fucking moving. It's not good. Yeah, don't buy a drone and fly it in Wellington. It's not a good idea. Shit, okay, I guess I'm gonna have to come back when it's a little less windy, but that's very unlikely because we're in the middle of winter. I'm so scared that my camera's gonna fucking blow away. Shit. So I'm gonna get some cool footage, but I suppose today is probably not the day for that. Unless I can find a little area that's not as windy, like down there, but there's a lot of construction going on, so yeah, I don't know. I suppose we're gonna have to come back and fly another day, or I'm gonna go find another place that is suitable for flight. Not here. Yeah, I was pretty scared the fucker's gonna blow away. It's very windy. I don't know if you guys can hear it or if you can see like the leaves blowing in the wind there. The thing is, it was fine like earlier this morning. I thought, you know, I had a chance to fly it, but I suppose it's picking up. Oh well, all right. Come back another day. Oh, and by the way, I've just picked up my drone from the ground and it's really dusty from taking off on the gravel. There's some dust near the gimbal, so I hope that doesn't ruin it. I think it's okay for the time being, but I should probably try and clean it out because that is not good. I'm a bit nervous to do it on here just in case it flies and boom, hits the... That's a weird one. In case it hits this. Man, I don't know. New to the world of drones and my hair is getting really messy right now, but there's some lessons to be learned today. Don't fucking fly. Don't fly in the wind. Don't fly over gravel. Don't fly on gravel. Like, the dust cloud looks really cool, and I've even got some dust on my camera now. But it gets fucked up. It just gets dust everywhere, man. Okay, alright, let's go home. It's really windy now. I'm cold. I did have one more attempt in a different location, but I totally forgot that there were these massive power lines in the way. I mean, here's this footage. I couldn't get a lot of altitude, and the power lines actually interfered with the compass calibration. I tried to recalibrate the compass, and it just wasn't having it. So, I mean, it did still kind of fly and maintain its position, but yeah, I probably need to try and find better locations apart from Wellington. And I can't really go out today because, I mean, you guys can't see, but the trees are like visibly moving. The wind is a lot heavier than it was yesterday. Okay, they were moving a lot more before, but this is definitely not drone flying weather. Focus, damn it! Yep, there we go. That's not drone flying weather. That is not drone flying weather! So yeah, if I'm gonna be honest, this video is a bit of a shambles. It's all in good fun though. I kind of just wanted to make a video about my new drone because I love these things. These are really cool pieces of kit to have in any filmmaker's arsenal. I mean, this for the price that it is, it's so accessible, and I'm very glad that DJI is powering. Very glad that DJI is pioneering. I'm very glad that DJI is powering. Fuck! I'm very glad that DJI is pioneering this kind of engineering and technology. And I mean, who knows what kind of drones we're going to have in a couple years time. Could they be even smaller, or could we get 4K in this thing and maybe get some better motors and USB-C, please. That's the only other downfall of this drone. But yeah, like I said, I'm going to try and capture some more cinematic footage and of a bit more scenic locations for you guys during my travels throughout New Zealand. And hopefully I don't get caught in any gusts and the drone doesn't blow away. Until then, don't fly drones in the wind, don't fly them on over gravel, and you should be good. So thanks for watching. I appreciate you guys sticking around all the way to the end. If you did enjoy the video, leave a like, subscribe for more content, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.